The past year, we've seen how filmmakers have had to adapt their filming to either abide by social distancing rules or postpone altogether. But with recent talk of lockdown restrictions lifted, our young creatives in the city are eager to get their projects finished. Now, local filmmaker Jack McLaughlin is currently working on his feature debut, Kate and Jake. The cast include Liverpool talent Chrissy Rock and Paul Barber. I had Jack and two of the main cast actors, Sarah Chadwick and Michael Latham, on the show in November, but Jack is back again. So Jack, how are you? Welcome back to the evening show, mate.
Oh, thanks for having me back on, Jermaine. It's a pleasure. Cheers.
No, it's great to have you on. So when we spoke in November, the plans were then, you know, lockdown was going to be reassessed, possibly thinking of starting to film, but then lo and behold, we get put back into lockdown again. So I'm guessing at this point, Kate and Jake still hasn't started rolling yet.
Yeah, we were all set to go ready, and then that happened. So we had to reschedule it now till May. We're going to start now.
Hopefully our listeners remember when you were on before and telling us about it. But just in case, or we've got some new people, why don't you tell us a bit about Kate and Jake and what it's all about?
Yeah, sure. So Kate and Jake, it's a feature film about a ex-couple who meet off one last time before one of them takes a job opportunity in Australia. And they basically spend the day together, and as they do, the film goes back and forth in time to show you what happens in their relationship and how it led to where they are now currently. Mm. And the film's set in Liverpool too, with mostly Liverpool cast. Yeah.
It does. I mean, you know, you've got a strong core of Liverpool actors there, your main cast, of course.
Yeah.
And you've got some well-known names in there too, right?
We've got Chrissy Rock in there, who people probably remember from Benidorm, and she was in a Ken Loach film called Lady Bird, Lady Bird, which was a fantastic film that she was in. And also Paul Barber, who people probably remember best as Denzel from Only Fools and Horses. And of course, he was in The Full Monty as well. So we're very, very blessed to have them on board.
So many people kind of say to themselves, oh, I'd love to make a film, or I'd love to do this. But not many people actually do it. So, you know, what got you excited about this genre and this field?
Well, it's something that I've always just been interested in, really. And I've made films ever since I was a kid, since I was about 11, without really thinking of that. You know what you said about people going, oh, well, I'll make it, but they never end up doing. Mm. We just ended up just doing it. And then, obviously, as the years have went on, I like to think I've evolved, really, as a filmmaker, as you do. Do you know what I mean? And you learn different things and stuff like that. But I think I was about 11 and I saw Slumdog Millionaire, do you know, the Danny Boyle film?
Of course, yeah. Great film.
And that really, like, stunned me, because I'd never seen a film like that before, because I was quite young, and I was like, it came up at the end, directed by Danny Boyle, and I was like, who's that? And then my dad told me, he's only from Radcliffe in Manchester, and he won Best Director at the Oscars. And I was like, it just blew me mad, because I thought that was only an American thing, do you know what I mean? To create stories for a living, and he was kind of the catalyst really of it all. And I was like, well, that's what I want to do, being a director, yeah.
What's one of your earliest memories of making film?
So we made a zombie film when we were about 11 or 12.
Oh, standard. And, you got to make a zombie film if you're a young director.
Definitely, yeah. It was with all the blood and guts and all that. And I remember, like, at the time, we were like, this is amazing. It's like, we thought, like, oh, it's brilliant, this and all that. And then looking back on it now, it's like, oh, God, it's terrible. But you got to start somewhere, haven't you?
Absolutely.
That's the thing. You know, I don't think any filmmaker looks back at the first work and goes, oh, yeah, I always knew it was going to be great. You know, you have to start from somewhere, and that's where your education begins, really. You know what I mean?
So you've not got no hidden gems recorded under the bed, and they're just waiting to be found?
No, they're all locked safely away. Never see the light of day then. No, Jermaine, no.
Recently, one of the things you were part of as well, you had a short film screened at the LA Film Festival, right?
Yeah, the Liftoff LA Festival, yeah. That was great.
What was that? How did that come about? And what was the film that you did?
The film was called Shopping List, and it was about this hitman who waits for his next target to appear. And then when his target does appear, he's kind of thrown into a bit of a moral dilemma. which he needs to act upon really quickly. And that idea, I had that for quite a while, and then this was 2019 now, so I'd just come out of university, and I hadn't made a short film for a while, and I was just like, I just want to make that one, because it was quite an easy shoot as well. There's no dialogue in it. It's all kind of music and sound driven, and I had great actors for it. And then, yeah, we submitted it to Liftoff LA Film Festival, and it got in and it got screened there. It was a virtual screening because of COVID. And then, yeah, I got interviewed by the guys there, and it was a great time. And
nice.
They had a really great festival, really great guys that run that.
It's a shame you didn't get to go over to LA and do it in person.
I know, yeah. I know, that was a big shame, because that's what I mean. I actually could have went over as well, but because, yeah, that COVID, we couldn't. But it is what it is, isn't it?
Right.
Maybe next time.
Well, back to Kate and Jake. So, you know, script is written. Actors are good to go. We've had to be...
Yeah.
It's been postponed a couple of times. I remember the last time you were on before... You're also hoping to collect a bit of money for the crowdfunder as well. How did that all go?
Yeah, that went brilliantly, yeah. I think, yeah, after our last interview with Jed, like we got a few more donations, which was amazing. And we actually got our budget now of the $5,000, which was incredible.
Awesome. So now we are hoping to be getting, you know, out of lockdown and moving back into some form of normality in the next couple months. So is the plan now then, once we're allowed to get out and about, just to start filming and get this film made?
Yeah, that's the plan. I mean, yeah, it's like once all the over 60s and 70s have been vaccinated by then, and the cases have gone down, that we can just go at it then, because the schedule's there now, and yeah, we just can't wait now to shoot it.
Have you got any plans on how you want to release it?
I think we're aiming for film festivals. That's the main thing for me at the minute. And then we're talking to a couple of sales agents at the minute about distribution, because obviously, like, getting into festivals, it's a great chance to get an audience, and then you have to distribute it, where that's where like a company will pick it up and put it on like Amazon or Netflix, or give it a limited run in the theatres, which would be amazing.
Awesome. So hopefully the festivals next year, we'll see Kate and Jake on the list of things to see on the playlists. If people want to go and check up on some of the work you've already done, Jack, or just keep tabs on your progress and see what you're doing, where can people go to kind of follow you?
Well, I've got I'm on all social media, so just on Facebook, just type in Jack McLaughlin and you'll find me there. Same on Instagram, Jack McLaughlin again. And then also, if you want to follow Kate and Jake, on Instagram, that's at Kate and Jake Film. Keep the updates with us and that through that page mostly, because we post quite frequently on there.